Today on Passion for Food, we make the Portuguese answer to the croque monsieur, the most epic sandwich of all time, the francesinha. There are a lot of variations on this mountainously cheesy sandwich, but today we're making a fairly traditional version with two kinds of sausage, ham, cheese, and steak, served with fries and covered in the most amazing steamy sauce to melt that cheese. Let's go ahead and get started here and make our sausage patty. We're going to be using two different kinds of sausage here. On the outside, we just have regular breakfast sausage, and in the middle, I'm going to be using some chorizo. I'm roughly basing my sandwich on how I saw it prepared in Café Santiago in Porto, Portugal. Once we have our sausages linked together, we just want to cook these off over medium-high heat. I'm going to cook this all the way through, and I like to get a nice sear on my sausage too. I'm sincere when I say that really adds a lot of great flavor. And there's a good reason why we decided to cook the sausage first. You can see all that wonderful fat that's rendering out here. Well, we're not going to waste that. We're actually going to use that fat to cook our steaks. So once we're happy with our sausage patty, we're going to go straight in here with a super thin ribeye steak. We can either have the friendly folks at your neighborhood meat counter cut these super thin for us, or if you're like me and you didn't feel like talking to anybody that day, you can just pound it out a little bit with a meat mallet. Just cover it in a little plastic and pound it thin. It's a steak, so it won't take much pressure at all. And the only seasoning I did to this was adding a little bit of salt to the top. All of that fat from our chorizo and sausage is going to have plenty of flavor to season the steak. We want to make sure we're getting a good sear on here. Otherwise, that would be a bit of a mistake. Anyway, once we're happy with that, we're just going to pull this off and set it aside while we make the francesinha's signature sauce. And we're going to make that right in this pan to take advantage of all these wonderful flavors we've developed. But depending on your sausage, you might have a little too much fat. We only want about a tablespoon. So I'm just going to go ahead and drain off all but approximately a tablespoon of that fat, as you can see here. One thing I noticed researching this recipe is almost every single recipe had a slightly different sauce. So I just decided to do my own thing here, starting with one large onion. And next up, we want 3 or 4 cloves of garlic, just roughly chopped. Carrots and celery would also be right at home here, as this is rather a French-inspired sauce. But I'm just going to stir these around to get a little bit of color going. After all, in cooking, browning always means flavor, thanks to the wonderful chemistry of the Maillard reaction. And speaking of wonderful chemistry, next up is the alcohol. I'm going to add 1 full 12-ounce beer here. Now, most of the sauces I saw also included port wine, which makes sense because port wine originates in Porto, Portugal, where this sandwich originates as well. But I decided just to do beer in mine. Hopefully that doesn't make the Portuguese hopping mad. To that, we're also going to add 1 full cup of chicken stock, along with about a tablespoon of crushed red pepper flakes. Those add a great hint of spiciness, and we also want a single bay leaf. I'm just going to give that a quick mix, and then to finish this off, we want 2 tablespoons of tomato paste. That's both going to make our sauce nice and tangy and act as a natural thickener. So we just want to get that incorporated, and then we simply want to cover this and simmer for about 30 minutes. And while that simmers, let's take just a quick moment and talk about the history of the francesinha sandwich. It was in 1953 when Daniel da Silva, a returning immigrant from France, first created the francesinha in a restaurant called A Regalaria. The sandwich was an attempt to adapt the French croque monsieur to the Portuguese taste, which he succeeded at swimmingly, as this sandwich is massively popular in Porto, Portugal to this day. It's said that he named it the Little Frenchie because of his appreciation for the beautiful, liberal women of France. Anyway, once our sauce has had about 30 minutes to simmer, we just want to take a moment and pull this bay leaf out of there. Now, don't forget and leaf that in there. Now, we could serve this rustic style. There's certainly nothing wrong with that. But I prefer to run kind of a smooth operation. So I'm going to use one of these immersion blenders and just blend this until it's completely smooth. Once it is, we simply want a taste for seasoning. Mine didn't need any, so we're just going to go ahead and cover this while we assemble our final francesinha sandwich. Starting with some nice toasty bread and a single slice of Havarti cheese. You can use whatever cheese you would like here. The cheese on the bottom is really just to protect this bread from the onslaught of meat that's about to happen. Starting with our sausage patty. Next up, our steak. And I've trimmed this a little bit just to get rid of some of the fat to avoid complaints from my wife. Next up is a fairly thick cut piece of smoked ham. And that's it. See, there's only four different kinds of meat on here. That's not that bad. We'll just put the top piece of bread on and give that a little press to seat things together. But hang on, we're not done yet. We still need to drape all four sides of this with individual pieces of Havarti cheese. Again, any kind of cheese will work. You want something that'll melt well, though. Some little Frenchy recipes actually top this with a runny egg as well, which I do think would be excellent, but I opted just for cheese here today. But we are going to serve this surrounded by fries. Something about all the fries, cheese, and gravy kind of makes me think of poutine a little bit. And there's no need to put this in the oven or anything to melt that cheese. That's what this piping hot gravy is for. I like to pour slowly in a couple of little batches, giving that cheese the time it needs to beautifully melt onto our French enseigne. It's like a four-sided cheese hug for our sandwich. This cheesy, gravy-covered monstrosity is really a wonder to behold. I'm going to attempt to slice this in half to give you a cross-section. Don't try this at home, kids. This is definitely a knife and fork kind of sandwich. But just look at that. Now, this is definitely a sandwich that I was pleased to meet. I really hope you've enjoyed today's episode of Passion for Food. If you have, give me a thumbs up below and don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell so you don't miss our future recipes. And check out one of the other great videos playing on the screen now. This has been Graham with Passion for Food. Along with about a tablespoon of crushed pepper flakes. What are these called?